Welcome to Angel Health Academy. Subject: Community Health Nursing. Topic for the day is Panchayati Raj System. Every village and town has their own peculiar problems, health related, social, economical problems. It is difficult to find the solution for them unless they meet and discuss each other and bring their decision into the force. This work is called Gram Rajya or Panchayati Raj. The word Panchayat means assembly of five, that is Ayat of Panch, and Raj means rule. Thus, the Panchayati Raj or village council rule is a political system originating from the Indian subcontinent. Under the Panchayati Raj system, every village is self-sufficient, and thus it is described as the pillar of village administrations. Panchayati Raj is the pillar of village administration. Panchayati Raj system mainly found in India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and Nepal. And even in India, some of the states such as Nagaland, Meghalaya, Mizoram and hilly areas of Manipur, they do not follow the Panchayati Raj system. Health system in the rural areas of the district are organized and administered through Panchayati Raj system, PRI or PRS. Panchayati Raj links the village to the district. Then Panchayati Raj institutions are accepted agencies of public welfare to provide public health services. All the development programs in the village are channeled through these bodies. Then history. Panchayati Raj system was first introduced and inaugurated by then Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru on 2nd October 1959 at Nagaur in Rajasthan. The first election under the Rajasthan Panchayat Samitis and Zilla Parishat Act 1959 were held in September and October 1959. The Mysore Gram Panchayat and Local Self-Governing Unit Act was introduced on 1st November 1959 as Rajyotsava Day. In India, Panchayati Raj Act was passed in 1952 as per the 73rd Amendment Act in our Constitution. Then later it came into force with effect from April 24, 1993. So we consider April 24th as National Panchayati Raj Day. Panchayati Raj Act was based on the recommendation given by Balwant Rai Mehta Committee. And Balwant Rai Mehta is considered as a father of Indian Panchayati Raj. He was the second chief minister of Gujarat and he considered as the architect of Panchayati Raj. The Lord Rippon Prabhu considered as father of Indian local self-government. The scheme of local self-government developed the municipal institutions which had been growing up in the country ever since. Aims of Panchayati Raj system. There are mainly three aims of Panchayati Raj system. First is give more power to the people in administration. Second is introduction of decentralization of power in administration, delegation of the power and responsibility. Third aim is work for the comprehensive progress and development of the village. Next is functions of Panchayati Raj system. There are three main functions. First is to function as institution of rural local self-government. Second function is to prepare plans for economic development, social justice and empowerment of the village. Third function is to implement rural development program or community development program in the rural area of the district. Next is Indian Panchayati Raj system. Panchayati Raj is a three-tier structure or three-tier institutions of rural local self-government in India. It consists three-tier structure or three institutions such as Panchayat, Panchayat Samadhi and Zilla Parishat. At village level, the institution is Panchayat. At block level, it is Panchayat Samadhi. And at district level, it is Zilla Parishat. Let us discuss in detail about Indian Panchayati Raj system. So, Panchayati Raj system or rural local self-government, at village level, it is known as Panchayat. It has got a three structure. That is Gram Sabha, Gram Panchayat and Nyaya Panchayat. At block level, Panchayati Raj system is known as Panchayat Samiti and at district level, it is known as Zilla Parishat. Let us discuss in detail about the Panchayat, Panchayat Samiti and Zilla Parishat. First is Panchayati Raj at village level. So at village level, Panchayati Raj institution consists of Gram Sabha, Gram Panchayat and Nyaya Panchayat. First is Gram Sabha. Gram Sabha is the assembly of all adult men and women in the village. That means all the voters of the ward. They meet at least twice a year. They have to or they must meet at least twice a year. That is every 6 months. The Indian Constitution Act envisages the Gram Sabha as the foundation of the Panchayati Raj system to perform the functions. And the power entrusted to it by the state legislature or state government. Purposes of Gram Sabha. First is to discuss the annual programs. Second, to decide various developmental aspects for the village. Then third one is consider the proposal for the taxation or tax. And fourth purpose is elect the members for the Gram Panchayat. Second organ is the Gram Panchayat. It is the executive organ of Gram Sabha. It is an agency for overall planning and development at the village level. Gram Panchayat is also called as the pillar of Grama Swarajya or Grama Swaraj. So, Grama Panchayat is formed in the following manner. That is, every village panchayat is divided into wards. That is, smaller areas. Each ward elects a representative who is known as the ward member or panch. The ward panches elect the sarpanch to form the Gram Panchayat. That is, the president of the Gram Panchayat. Thus, Gram Panchayat is formed by 15 to 30 elected members. And it is headed by Sarpanch Sabhapadi Mukhya or President. The head of the Gram Panchayat is called as Sarpanch or Sabhapadi or Mukhya or even Panchayat President. It covers a population of 5,000 to 15,000. And this committee is expected to, or Gram Panchayat is expected to meet at least once in 2 months. The organization of Gram Panchayat includes a president, a vice president, panchayat secretary, various standing committees and ward members. The secretary of the panchayat or panchayat secretary is a non-elected representative that is directly appointed by the state government to oversee all the panchayat activities. The term of the elected representatives of the Gram Panchayat is 5 years. The period of one Gram Panchayat is 5 years. Next is functions of Gram Panchayat. There are more than 10 functions. First is education. Second is public health. Third is safe water supply. Fourth one is food campaign. Fifth is sanitation and drainage. Sixth is street lights. Seventh one is housing. Eighth is establishing khadi and village industries. The ninth one is management of any public ferry. Then social and economic development. And last other functions. Let us discuss in detail about the functions of Gram Panchayat. First one is education, that is primary, social, technical, vocational, adult education and non-formal education. Then second function is public health. Render the public health services through rural dispensaries, various health centers, sub-centers, primary health centers, etc. and maternity and child welfare centers. Then third function is safe drinking water or irrigation. Fourth function is grow more food campaigns. Fifth function is sanitation and drainage in the Gram Panchayat. The sixth function is maintenance of street lights. Seventh is housing. Eighth one is establishing khadi and village industries. And ninth function is management of any public ferry if available there. Tenth is social and economic development of the village. Planning and implementing various programs for the social and economic development of the village and others. The next is facilities for the citizen at Gram Panchayat. Gram Panchayat provide many facilities for the citizen. First is registration of marriage and issuance of marriage certificate. Second is registration of birth and death and issuance of both birth and death certificates. Then NOC for doing any business, that is business NOC certificate or trade license. Fourth one is MNREGA job card, that is Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, the supply of that job card to the workers. Then collecting house tax, issuing property valuation certificates, giving permission to the building, that is building permissions, and giving water tap connections, issuing or issuance of residence certificate, and the last is 10th one is others. Gram Panchayat also has some vested powers. First is promotion of educational, economic, social, cultural and other interests of the scheduled caste, scheduled tribes and other backward classes. Then protection of such castes and classes from social injustice and any form of exploitation. The Gram Panchayat has also got the power of welfare of women and children. The third structure is the Nyaya Panchayat. Nyaya Panchayat is formed by 5 elected members from the village. And one Nyaya Panchayat is responsible for 5 Gram Panchayat. The functions of Nyaya Panchayat is try to solve the disputes between the 2 parties or groups of the people in the Panchayat. Then deals with the legal aspects of the village. So Nyaya Panchayat is formed by 5 elected members and one Nyaya Panchayat is responsible for the 5 Gram Panchayat. They try to solve the dispute between the peoples and deals with the legal aspects of the village. The second institution is Panchayati Raj system at block level. So at block level, or also known as intermediate level, Panchayat Samadhi is a rural local self-government at the intermediate tehsil, that is taluka or mandal level in India. It works for the villages of the tehsils. One tehsil consists 200 to 600 villages that together are called a development block or block development. A community development block consists about 100 villages and it covers a population of 80,000 to 1,20,000 people. At block level, the Panchayati Raj institution consists of, or it is known as Panchayat Samadhi or Block Samadhi or Janapada Panchayat or Mandal Parishat or Taluk Panchayat. The Panchayat Samadhi at block level also said to be Panchayat of Panchayats. Then Panchayat Samadhi is headed by Block Development Officer BDO. The Block Development Officer is a official in charge of a block. He monitors the implementation of all the programs relating to planning and development of the blocks, especially implementation of the community development programs. So next is members of Panchayat Samadhi. Panchayat Samadhi includes all sarpanches of the Gram Panchayats or village panchayat in the community development block, which belongs to community development block, all the MLAs in the block, all the MPs, member of parliaments residing in the block area, and the representatives from women, scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, and from cooperative societies. So these are the members of Panchayat Samadhi. Next is functions of Panchayat Samadhi. There are 7 functions of Panchayat Samadhi. First is execution of community development program in the block. So implementation of community development programs in the block. And second function is prepare the annual plan and budget for the Samadhi. Third one is prepare the agricultural extension programs for the block. Prepare the agricultural extension programs. Fourth function is conservation of soil and land developments. Fifth function is promoting the use of non-conventional energy resources for the block. Then sixth function is primary, higher and technical education. Providing, rendering primary, higher and technical education to the members of the block. Then seventh is other functions. First function is execution of community development program in the block level. That is the prime functions of the Panchayat Samadhi. The funds are provided by the government, state government, for the stage 1 and stage 2. Stage 1 is called as, that is 5 years duration, that is intensive phase, and second phase also 5 years duration, that is post intensive phase. So all the funds provided by the government are channeled through the Panchayat Samadhi for the execution of the community development program. Then second function is to prepare the annual plan and budget as suggested by the government or the Zilla Panchayat at district level. Third function is prepare agricultural extension programs and request for the grants from the government. Next is seventh functions, others. Both block development officer and his staffs provide technical assistance and guidance to the village Panchayat who engaged in the developmental work. Next is Panchayati Raj system at district level. So at district level, Panchayati Raj system or Panchayati Raj is known as Zilla Parishat or Zilla Panchayat. It is the agency of rural local self-government in the district. Zilla Parishat or Zilla Panchayat is headed by a chairman or an adhyaksha. The membership of Zilla Parishat is fairly large, varying from 40 to 70. That means a member is selected for every 40,000 people in general area, and in Malnad and hilly area, one member is selected for 30,000 people in the district. The members of Zilla Parishad includes, first is the collector, actually is a non-voting member, and all Panchayat Samadhi heads, all the Panchayat Samadhi heads in the district, that is all the BDOs, block development officers, all the MLAs and MPs of the district, all the MLAs and MPs of the district, and representatives of women, scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, cooperative society, and moreover, two experienced persons in administration, public health or rural development. Then functions of Zilla Parishad. The first function is supervise and coordinate the community development program carried out by the Panchayat Samadhi. So supervision and coordination. Second function is extension plans for agriculture and horticulture in the district. Third function is use of water resources and its maintenance. Fourth function is use of non-conventional energy resources. Fifth function is women and child welfare programs, RCH programs or women and child welfare programs. Sixth function is social developments of the disabled and mentally retarded in the district. Seventh function is providing facility for reading room and library, that is reading room and library developments and others, other functions. So, in short, the Zilla Parishad is primarily a supervisory and a coordinating body. Its functions and powers vary from actually state to state. In Gujarat, the district health officer DHO and the district family planning and MCH officers are under the control of the Zilla Panchayat. So, that means the functions will be vary from and varies from state to state. So, let us summarize the topic. So, in short, Panchayati Raj system is a three-tier structure of rural, local, self-government for the progression and development of the villages. The districts are headed by the collector and it is divided by two or three subdivisions. Then that is headed by sub-collector or assistant collector. And each subdivision is again divided into tehsils or talukas headed by tehsildar. One talukas or tehsils consists 200 to 600 villages. Each tehsils or taluks again divided into community development block with 100 villages headed by block development officer. And the district also divided into rural and urban areas. The health system in the rural area of the district is done by Panchayati Raj system. At village level, it is known as Panchayat. At block level, it is known as Panchayat Samadhi. And at district level, it is known as Zilla Parishad. That's all about the topic. So, thanks for watching. Hope this video really benefits in your studies. If you feel it is worth and benefits in your studies, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Stay tuned with Angel Health Academy till we meet with another important educational video. Thank you.